This is part 3 of the Stoichiometry 101 series. In this video, we're going to look at solving mass A to mole B question. Here's the stoichiometry plan we'll be using. I've explained the plan in the first two videos, so do check them out if you haven't seen them. I go through in detail how the plan is developed and how to use it to set up solutions for stoichiometry problems. The link is on the top and in the description box below. Now let's read the question. We're given an equation and asked to find the moles of Na2S2O3 that are needed to react with 42.7 grams of AgBr. So the first thing we need to do is find out what we have, and that's 42.7 grams of AgBr. And what does the question want? It's moles of Na2S2O3. Since we're dealing with two substances here, which is AgBr and Na2S2O3, we'll call them A and B respectively. A is for what's given, B is for what we need to find. So our starting point is what we have and ending point is what the question wants. Next, we'll tag our start and end point on our stoichiometry plan. So our start point is grams A and end point is moles B. Looking at the plan, it will take two steps to go from grams A to moles B. Before we begin setting up to solve the question, we need to make sure that we have a balanced equation. So if you need a refresher on balancing equation, I'll link a video on the top. So it looks like we can easily balance this equation by placing a 2 in front of Na2S2O3. With that, we are now ready to set up the solution. In step 1, we'll go from grams A to moles A, and in step 2, we'll go from mole A to mole B. A in this case, like I mentioned before, is AgBr, and B is Na2S2O3. Step 1 is to divide the given mass, 42.7 grams, with the molar mass of A, which is AgBr. That comes out to be 187.77 grams per mole. If you need a refresher on calculating molar mass, I'll link the video on the top as well. So we take 42.7 grams and divide it with 187.77 grams per mole, and we get 0.2274 mole. What we have just calculated is mole A, which is the mole of AgBr. Moving on to step 2, we are supposed to multiply what we got from step 1 with the coefficient ratio. From the balance equation, coefficient B is the number in front of Na2S2O3, which is 2. Coefficient A is the number in front of AgBr, which is 1. So we take 0.2274 mole and multiply with 2 over 1, and that gives us 0.4548 mole. If you need to present it in 3 significant figure, then it's 0.455 mole. That's the mole of Na2S2O3, which is what the question wants us to find. To recap, we start off by reading the question and figuring out the information we have and what the question wants. Then we figure out the pathway using the plan. Before we proceed, if the question involves two substances, A and B, then we need to make sure that our equation is balanced. Once we get that sorted out, we follow the setup and solve the problem. You can solve practically any stoichiometric questions this way, successfully every time. For more examples, watch out for more videos in this Stoichiometry 101 series. Hope the video was helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.